Welcome up Candace Luce and Michael Poulin.
My name is Dennis Luce, and I'm the Republican candidate from Skeen County Sheriff. Born and raised in Ravana, I graduated Ravana Public Schools. After graduation, I joined the U.S. Army, served in the infantry at Fort Benning, Georgia, Camp Casey, Korea. Ended my time in the service, and I returned back home to my hometown and started working at Briggs & Stratton in the foundry. During that time, I was attempting to take classes at Baker College, which is very difficult working in a foundry setting, a lot of overtime. Then I had the opportunity, after a few years, I met my wife, who's a third grade teacher at Beachnaw Elementary in Ravana. She's the one that really encouraged me to pursue my dreams and goals in law enforcement. So I resigned from Briggs & Stratton and I began working for the Ottawa County Sheriff's Office as a corrections officer in the jail. And I attended MCC, finished MCC, transferred to Grand Valley, attended the police academy. Once I was finished with the academy, the sheriff's office in Ottawa County allowed me to transfer over to the road patrol, where I've served as general road patrol, community policing, school resource officer, and a sergeant. Currently a sergeant assigned to the city of Coopersville, which contracts for policing services through the sheriff's office, which greatly reduce their budget for policing, and they actually get more services by contracting through the sheriff's office. So I'm in charge of that position, and it comes with budgeting, scheduling, and I do some grant writing for a nonprofit organization that I chair called the NEO Forum. It's a community police officer and school counselor that work together, promotes education on drugs, alcohol, and tobacco, the dangers of, and along with suicide prevention. So I feel Ottawa County, we really do a lot of really good things in the sheriff's office. And that's where I step in and say, I really want to bring my experiences from a new, different insight from another department, different experiences, and bring them here to Muskegon County. Really feel like they could really benefit Muskegon County. And a lot of it is based off from the customer service aspect. What can we do with the resources that we have to improve the customer service to our Muskegon County residents? And that is, we need to reach out to our local municipalities and our school districts and build relationships for future community policing initiatives. I also have some other ideas as well that we could provide more customer service to our residents.
Thank you, Dennis. Michael.
Thank you. My name is Michael Poulin, and I'm the Democratic nomination for the sheriff's position. Past April, I retired from the sheriff's office after 29 years of service to the people here in the county of Muskegon, the last 27 at the sheriff's office. I retired as captain. I was third in command. During my tenure with the sheriff's office, I worked 15 years as rank coordinator, 12 years as SWAT team commander. I'm currently in my fourth term as a school board member for North Muskegon Public Schools, where I've been the board president for the last 10 years. I also sit on the board of directors, the advisory board for the Muskegon County Health Project, and also the board of directors for Pioneer Resources. My wife Susan and I have been married 20 years, celebrating our anniversary yesterday. We have two boys, Gavin and Garrett. Our youngest is a junior at North Muskegon Public Schools, and our oldest is off to college. He had received an appointment to the United States Military Academy's preparatory school at West Point. So we're quite proud of him. That's why I cite that. I am a graduate of Grand Valley State University and also Northwestern University School for Police Staff and Command. In 2012, I graduated from the FBI Academy in Quantico, the National Academy in Quantico, Virginia. When I ran, when I retired on April 18th, I went down and filed on that day, the day of my retirement. And the one thing that I promised to the citizens of Muskegon County was that I would bring back integrity and accountability to the sheriff's office. The fact that I'm here right now, right, is a promise and a guarantee that that's going to happen. This may be a little unheard of, especially during a debate, but I say this because no matter who gets elected in this race, I know Dennis Luce and I know myself, and that will happen for sure. All right, the question for the voters. question for the voters is, who are they going to want to do that? Who has the training, the experience, the professional development, and the community alliance here in Muskegon County? You know, I love this community. Spent the last 37 years here as a resident. Plan to stay here the rest of my life. And I really would appreciate any consideration for this upcoming election. Thank you.
Now we can turn it over to the audience and see if we have any questions from the audience. Yes, Brenda.
You talk about building alliances with the schools and the children. What is your goal and how would you do that? And do you feel it's the department's responsibility to teach the students about drugs and crime and make them more aware of what's going on?
Dennis,
a
couple of minutes.
Yes, absolutely. You know, community policing is very instrumental. It's huge. It's very important in society nowadays to build that relationship between the community and law enforcement. Law enforcement can only do so much. Law enforcement needs community support. Without community support, you know, law enforcement's going to fall short. And especially you watch the media today and everything else. That's why community policing is so important, to get in front of the issues, to be more proactive than reactive in a lot of our approaches, to become involved in the communities that we serve. Now, it's going to, with the budget issues and facing the jail and everything else, it's going to be a process. It's not going to happen overnight, but I would like to have a school resource officer in each school to do that, to teach classes, and to be that go-to person for a lot of the kids. I tell you, I served as a school resource officer, and that was probably one of my most rewarding positions that I've ever had in my career. Even now, in my position as supervisor, I have people that come to me and want to trust me because of that relationship that I've built. And that's why it's important to build those relationships. Now, these are typically funded through the municipalities and the schools and a portion of the sheriff's office. And that's why it's so important to also be there at the events, the local events, to just have that community support within policing.
Michael?
Thank you. These alliances obviously are very important. I've made it part of my career as one of the founders and a chair for the Muskegon County Alcohol Liability Initiative. And this is a program through the Health Project where we're able to reach out to the students at our local school districts here in Muskegon County. And really, this program was designed to get the students the proper information so they weren't, you know, getting misinformation from their friends. It's been a very successful program. As part of that, we won actually a national award out in Washington, D.C. for this program. But also, I'm looking forward to getting back and finishing the work that we did on the Safe School Initiative that we've been working on here in Muskegon County. And this is during our lockdown drills that we're doing, where we're getting more officer involvement from area agencies, because I think we can all trust that if there's ever an incident here in Muskegon County at one of our districts, every law enforcement officer that can respond will be responding. And they need to know what that district looks like. And so we've been working together with area agencies when we do these drills and bringing the officers together at that time from there. I do agree with Dennis about the school resource officers. You know, we've had it here in Muskegon County in the past, but we've heard this, you know, the conversations already. We understand the funding at the schools and, you know, here at Muskegon County. You know, and he can correct me if I'm wrong, but I believe the Ottawa County Sheriff's Office puts out the main officers on a day shift as the Sheriff's Office has totally. All right, so it's really not a good comparison of apples to apples from there, but I do believe having an officer in a school is key, I mean, to communication and to safety for the children.
Another question from the audience. Yes, sir.
First, I'd like to say that appreciate, like, how both of you are, you know, able to get along so well.
And we made a promise.
My question's for Mike. You said that if you're elected into the county sheriff's position, that you would bring integrity and accountability back to the sheriff's department. I just want to know, like, specifically what that meant and like what you would do once you were elected.
Well, I don't want to say if we can have a private conversation. I'd like to say the past is past. I'm not here to beat up on anybody. And, you know, we're through the primary election. Their past administration has made some poor personal decisions that have reflected poorly on this community as a whole. And, you know, really, I think if we move forward here, and that's where I'd like to go and look at this, you know, morale's at an all-time low at the sheriff's office. You know, I've had a brief opportunity while I was still working there to work as jail administrator, and during that time, I was able to reduce sick time usage, reduce vacation time usage, got everybody working as a team during that period because they wanted to come to work, right? But, you know, that platform about the accountability and integrity, that was my platform, if you will, which I promised to carry through. And like I've already said, it's going to happen no matter what, right? That will happen no matter what. But that was my platform for the primary, for sure, number one. Okay, so I know I didn't answer your question, but it's about the best I can do right now.
Dennis, would you like to comment?
All right. Well, there's a lot of really good deputies that work for the Muskegon County Sheriff's Office. I know quite a few of them. I don't know all of them. You know, a lot of my relationships have been in Ottawa County. But I do know, in any leadership position, you need to set clear expectations and standards with your employees. And that's where it needs to start. You know, when I get in there, we're gonna have to sit down with the deputies and just explain to them, these are our expectations here. The standards are much higher than they're used to. And, you know, you can either get on board with these standards, or unfortunately, there's a lot of other people out there that are looking for jobs.
All right, that's our time. Yes, quickly. I still got 33 seconds here.
Go ahead. I'll take your time. No, I just follow. I mean, we talk about the accountability, though, and that. And the accountability has to start at the top. And obviously, that's exactly what Dennis is talking about. We need to hold ourselves accountable, especially in this position. And that's something that hasn't been going on for a long time. The decisions need to be based out of this office on our community, not for personal gain from there. I said it before in one of the media releases here, it's just what Dennis is saying too. A lot of great, outstanding individuals that I love and adore work at the sheriff's office, and they are looking for direction and leadership. Thank you.